Well, today is October 1st, 2020. And the world's gone mad, but we're having a good old time back here. We just finished up pretty much all the first layer board siding. All but right here at the doorway. So I'm going to wait and get my door down here and frame it all into the size of the door and trim it out. That'll be next step, get a door on this damn thing. And then I can start with the batten boards. But I just do a walk around. A lot of this stuff, like right here, I just let it run wild, and I'll come back with the skill saw and cut it up flush. And I nailed, you know, this board into this board, so it's tight. And did that on pretty much all the corners. So, you know, button these up as tight as I can with a nail going in here. Same here. You know, if you got a little gap here, that's fine, because you're going to have a corner board here and one coming here. It's going to form a nice, you know, 90 degree box corner there. And then you'll have your batten board, batten board, batten board, and you'll see all that in time lapse. And then I'll trim out the windows with the same batten boards and probably caulk those up. I don't know, I might not even trim them. It doesn't need it for waterproofing, it's just a looks thing. So after our camping experiment, we certainly got to get a door on here, and then we get this thing closed in. I got my little corners I got to do right here, the little triangles, but that's good progress. Not bad for, I don't know, probably, I guess it's 6 months just piddling with it, but we got something now. Hopefully, knock on wood, a tree doesn't fall on. Sergio is just cleaning up. Good man right here. You can see how muddy it still is. It poured the other day. It's squishy down here. Well, that's our door. That used to be our old front door to the house before I put new siding on it. And then we got all this crap that has been built up on it, piled up in the garage. So Ava and I got to get that thing out, because that's going on the cabin. I know I was saving it for some reason.
So much junk. Goodness. Horseshoe knocker. My gosh. All this spider web and crap. It's getting ready to rain. You think we should take it out or wait? We'll take it down there now, I guess.
Let me pull it out in the sun.
Alright, come on over here.
That's a good solid wood door. So
solid.
It just needs cleaning up bad. Maybe I'll just let it get rained on. All right. Got to take a broom to it. Thank you.
boy, this door must be like 100 pounds. Is it gonna fit in the doorway? As long as it's smaller than the door, we're good. Oh yeah, it'll fit. That's gonna be a nice door. Set it off to the side. Just nice to get this door down here before it starts raining. So we don't have to run the tractor on the muddy trail.
Man, rain's coming and the leaves are falling. Today is October the 11th. Muddy. Well, it's time to get this door installed. For you all, this video is probably about halfway over. For me, I haven't been down here in about a month. Last I was down here, we dropped the door off. Since then, I've been busy on the farm. I've been busy in the wood shop. Had to build a river table for a customer. That turned out real good. We got this cool Honda Pioneer 1000. We sold the old Yamaha. That was a 2006 Yamaha Rhino 660. It served us well, but you know, we needed something bigger, and the kids are growing and we need more room. I'm doing more and more back here in the woods, so this thing has a bigger bed. It seats five people. The bed turns into two jump seats pop up. I'll do a full review on this thing a little later when I get some more time on it, but I'm really enjoying it so far. But without any further ado, let's get this door installed. When framing a door in, I kind of steer away from getting too permanent until everything's working. And these nails are easily pulled out. If I have to shim any of these legs, I can put a flat bar in there and open it up
and ease a shim in there and make my adjustments. Not looking too bad. This thing is close enough, I believe, to mount with the hinges and adjust it on the frame. And we'll do that next. Right here, you can see it's already mortised out for the hinges. Okay. I will do the same thing on this side and I'll show you how I do that so you get a tight fit and it doesn't make the door stick out and present a gap. All right, the hinges are on. What I'm gonna do down here is I'm gonna set the door on something. So we have these as shims. These scraps of wood are an inch thick. Put one on each side. So when you set your door in place, you don't have to worry about that. They're the same board, so they're even. And then we're gonna go ahead and set the door in here and mark our hinges where we're gonna have to do our hinge cutout on this side. And the door swings in, so you gotta get the door inside. And something's going to hit. Oh, and you gotta put yourself on the right side of the door too. There. All right. No shim too tall. So we're gonna put smaller shims down there, so it can go underneath of it. About an eighth too tall. Not much, just a scotch. All right. Where the hell's my pencil? So I'm going to make a fine line on the top and bottom of each one of these hinges. And then I'm going to carry that line around the corner to the inside of the jamb. And then I'll take these hinges and trace them and mortise them out so they can sit inside the surface of the jamb. And I'll show you how to do that. So in order, I always say, you know, you got to have a sharp pencil. Well, nothing sharper than a razor knife. So I'm just going to mark it with this razor knife. Right there. All right. It's marked. Need a dang pencil. Lines, boom, boom, carry those around the corner. Just like that. What I'm doing here is marking where this hinge intersects the door. Okay, put a little mark there. Now I'm gonna knock this pin out and we'll use this hinge to trace onto the door jamb. See the marks?
Hey, Ava, how are you? How was your day at school?
Tiring.
Okay. Let's see. Ava, you want to hold the camera? Let me turn this around. So we're going to dig this out. We're going to do that with... with this tool. We're just going to use this router and set the depth up on this to be as deep as this. Boom. Just like that. So I ripped down a piece of poplar siding to about 3/8 of an inch right here and put this stop trim all the way around in here, as you can see. And so when you shut the door, it's got something to slam against. See? Boom. And then on the hinges, what I'm going to do is come back and remove one of these small screws on each one. I might go ahead and do that now and put in a 3-inch deck mate that goes all the way into the stud, so it's not just screwed to this thing that's nailed on with finish nails. This sweep here was installed with these little teeny fillet or flat blade screws, and you know, I don't have flooring down yet, so what I did was bought a sweep, a door sweep there, and then I'm gonna go ahead and install that so it goes right down to the subfloor. And then when I go ahead and put my final flooring in, I'll readjust it. But I just want to try to keep as many varmints out of here for now as possible. So if I can keep, you know, my goal is keep mice out, which will end up just keeping the raccoons out. So that's how it is with varmints. You try to keep out the ants, you might just keep out the mice. So my goal now is just keeping the big stuff out in the squirrels. But that's where we're at. I finally got this door done. That thing fought me every step of the way. It was not easy, but I got it in there. It looks all right. So we finally got a locking doorknob, a deadbolt, a door that fits. I still have to Every time I come down here, I forget to bring my black plane. One of these days I'll bring it, but I got to shave it down right here. But that's just my memory getting bad. So I got to do a little shaving there. But all in all, it's in there. Had to do some butchering on the door, but... And then this sweep down here, I had to put that extender piece on there because we don't have any kind of subfloor going on right now. And I still wanted to just sweep the bottom because, you know, we're out in the woods. And, you know, normally on a construction site, you can, you know, wait until the finished floor goes down. But I don't know when that'll be. So I want this thing sealed up now. So I just tacked on that little piece of poplar so I could put that sweep a little further down. And when I come in with a finished floor, that'll raise the flooring height 3/4 of an inch. I'll take the piece of poplar off of there and put a new sweep on there. But for now, that takes care of critters coming in here. Let me show you down here. What I'll do here is all these joists are going to get a connecting 2x8 in here that run underneath this floor to help support and strengthen this piece of subfloor plywood. And then up to this will be my decking for the front deck, which will probably most likely be this 3/4 inch oak I've cut, red oak. And so that'll butt in here. And then the finished floor will come in. And then I'll come in with a piece of marble threshold that'll be 3/4 of an inch thick. I'll notch this piece and slip it under there, and it'll cover this transition, this gap, and shed water that'll probably never get here, but shed out on top of the deck. So that'll take care of that transition. And then I just ripped down a little piece of poplar here for a stop, 3/8 of an inch thick, to have this thing something to slam into, and then done. So it's tight. If I wanted to put some weather stripping on it, I could, but it's pretty tight right now. So not bad. Stand back and see how it looks. With it, sun's blaring. Looks good, I think. Now for now, some things I don't like about this cabin right now, the way it's... First of all, we got to get rid of these 2x4 posts and get something substantial in there. I got some oak 12x12s I cut for a customer that I'm going to quarter down and make into 6x6s and put in there. I think that'll give it a nice beefy look. Also, I want to go ahead in the next video. I think I'm going to start at least put my electrical cups inside to start the electrical rough end so we can get some insulation inside. Kids really want to go camping again. So it's getting colder. You know, here it is. Yesterday was November. Yeah, it's November 4th. So we the election was yesterday. We might know the results of that in the next month or so. But anyway, I'm hiding in the woods. Anyway, as usual, like, share, and subscribe. And God bless you. Thank you.